Feeling hot, hot, hot.
Hello, I'm Holly Nicholson, Miss Florida Teen USA 1988. Many young ladies dream of having this crown. It's mine now, but tonight I must pass it on. And one girl's dream will come true, and her life will change forever. Who will it be?
Olé, 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 olé. Feeling hot, hot, hot. Feeling hot, hot, hot. Feeling hot, hot, hot. Feeling hot, hot, hot.
From the Marco Polo Resort in Sunny Isles, it's the 1989 Miss Florida Teen USA pageant. Welcome our 37 young ladies competing for the crown as they reach the tropical beaches and island rhythms of South Florida.
Me mind on fire, me soul on fire,
feeling hot, hot, hot.
Party people all around me,
feeling hot, hot, hot.
What to do?
So we can rum, bum, bum, bum. Let me rum, bum, bum, bum. Olé, 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 olé. Olé, 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 olé. Let me rum, bum, bum, bum. Let me rum, bum, bum, bum.
We'll be starting the competition after these messages. Don't go away or you'll miss it.
Miami Seaquarium says thanks, South Florida, for your support. Hi, I'm Mark, trainer at the Miami Seaquarium. Haven't you ever wanted to be a trainer for a day? Well, now through Christmas, we're giving away prizes every hour, including Kodak cameras, Sea Escape cruises, T-shirts, and a once-in-a-lifetime experience to be a trainer for a day. Go to your participating Wendy's and pick up a discount coupon, and it's our way of saying thanks, South Florida.
Come on out for a day of fun at the Miami Seaquarium.
Miss Teen USA! Miss Teen USA!
The next name called could be yours. If you're between the ages of 14 and 18, applications are now being accepted for the 1990 Miss Florida Teen USA pageant. It's the official preliminary for the Miss Teen USA pageant. For more information, send a postcard with your name, address, telephone number, and date of birth to Tel Air Interest, 1755 Northeast 149th Street, Miami, Florida, 33181.
Introducing Popete, the amazing new food storage system with an incredible accordion construction that actually expands and collapses. You create the size you need. Collapse the container to fit the food to save the space. Only one glass left. Put it in Popete and look at the difference. Do your cabinets look like this? With Popete, you'll save so much space it's like having an extra cabinet in your kitchen. Complete with airtight lids to keep food its absolute freshest. They're dishwasher safe and microwave safe. You'll get 3-quart size Popete, 3-quart and a half size pieces, 3 half-gallon pieces, and the giant half-gallon bottle that collapses this small for easy travel. Now only $19.95. 9 containers, the bottle, lids, 20 pieces in all. Here's how to order.
Credit card users call toll-free 1-800-272-8900. That's 1-800-272-8900. Or send just $19.95 plus $3 shipping to Popete, Box 700-H, Verona, New Jersey, 07044. Or call 1-800-272-8900.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome our host and hostess for tonight, Miss Arkansas USA 1987. And now a rising singer on the Nashville Network, Sherry Smeltzer. And the Dean of Miss USA State Pageant MCs, Dick Lamb.
Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome indeed to Miss Florida Teen USA 1989. Now, before we're finished here, at least one lucky young lady is going to begin a rather exciting adventure.
That's right, and the excitement is building in anticipation of that moment. This weekend, the 38 young ladies have been competing in their preliminary competition, which involves evening gown, swimsuit, and personality judging.
Just about ready to let you know the names of the 12. Just these 12 may now continue after the title of Miss Florida Teen USA. Our first semi-finalist is Kimberly Polk. Our next semi-finalist is Karen Cash. Semi-finalist, Tina Cirillo. And next joining this group of lucky young ladies is Lisa Warren. Our fifth semi-finalist, Michelle Benitez. Semi-finalist, Debbie Knox. Now that's just half the number, halfway home we are. The next semi-finalist is Dana Wiener. Semi-finalist, Laura Kuda. And next on our list, semi-finalist, Virginia Norton. Three more to go, three more names. The next, Dana Rosenhaus. Semi-finalist, Lori McGinnis. One more name. That semi-finalist is Renee Pitts. Ladies and gentlemen, there we have our semi-finalists for Miss Florida Teen USA.
To heat up as Dick interviews our 12 lucky young ladies in their personality competition. We'll be right back to hear just what the ladies come up with for answers after these few minutes.
Miami Seaquarium says thanks, South Florida, for your support. Hi, I'm Mark, trainer at the Miami Seaquarium. Haven't you ever wanted to be a trainer for a day? Well, now through Christmas, we're giving away prizes every hour, including Kodak cameras, Sea Escape cruises, T-shirts, and a once-in-a-lifetime experience to be a trainer for a day. Go to your participating Wendy's and pick up a discount coupon, and it's our way of saying thanks, South Florida.
Come on out for a day of fun at the Miami Seaquarium.
Ready now to chat with each one of our semifinalists. Poise and personality is what our judges check here. Let's get underway with it. First is Kimberly Polk. Kimberly, come on out and join us here. Kimberly is 18 years old from Leesburg at Leesburg High School. Well, what's going to happen for you when high school is all over, Kimberly?
Well, I just finished my semester exams, and then after that, I have three more quarters to go, And then after that, I plan to go on to college on my Who's Who scholarship.
Now, what are you going to study, do you suppose?
Fashion designing. I love clothes and I love working with material.
I saw a quick note here about one of your awards, Excellent in Photography Award. How'd you get that?
Yes, I was in Photography 1 and I was in Photography 2. And my teacher liked my work. I did double lapse photography and everything, and I love taking pictures.
You think that will play any part in your future at all?
Probably.
Well, I hope so. In whichever direction, I trust that things will work out very nicely for you. Good luck.
Thank you.
Kimberly Polk. And next, let's have Karen. Karen Cash joins us now. Karen from Miami, 17 years old, high school student at Palmetto Senior High. Well, Karen, then when you're all finished at Palmetto, what kind of an ambition plan do you have?
Well, I'd like to go to Florida State University and pursue a career in fashion.
Why have you chosen that field?
I love clothes. I'd someday like to be a fashion designer or a fashion merchandiser. I love clothes and I'd love to travel, and I'd like to combine the two and have a career in it.
Have you had a chance to do any traveling, let's say, with your family yet?
Yes, my mother's from England and we travel to Europe a lot. And I've been all over Europe and I've been almost all over the United States, and I love traveling.
When you think about pursuing a future career, would you leave home? Would you leave this area? Would you go New York, Los Angeles, or would you like to stay close to home?
Well, I was born in Miami and I've lived here all my life. I don't think I'd want to go far from Miami. That's why I want to go to Tallahassee for college, because I don't want to leave Florida.
And then when you get into the work world, probably still stay in this area.
Yes, I want to stay in Miami.
We're glad to hear that. Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Karen Cash. Tina Cirillo. Tina from North Miami Beach, going now to St. Leo College.
That's right.
Just started, I guess.
Yeah, I'm a freshman.
How you doing?
I'm doing great. I love the school. It's small. It gives you enough individual attention so you don't feel lost.
What are you preparing for?
I'm majoring in dance, and I'm also minoring in communication, so I have something to fall back on. I love dancing and singing and the arts.
Have you done any professional appearances, anything in front of an audience?
Just plays in high school, and we're preparing now for a dance concert in the next 4 weeks.
Tell me where you see yourself. What do you dream of, dancing-wise, when you're out there on a stage? Where would you like to see yourself performing?
I would love to see myself performing on Broadway.
Well, what's the line of progress? When you get finished school, how do you go on and prepare and go for that goal?
You have to be very positive and have an open mind and just be the best that you can be, and you'll be successful in whatever it may be.
I hope that turns out for you. Good luck.
Thank you.
There is Tina Cirillo. Lisa Warren is next from Clearwater. Clearwater High School student, 17 years old. You really want to be a news anchor woman?
Yes, I would really like to work with the public. That's why I want to go into it.
Well, you want to be in television and in broadcasting in general?
Yes, I would like to be exactly like Maria Shriver.
Why? Tell me why.
I really admire her. I feel that she's really worked her way to the top of her field. She's very talented, and she's just really great at what she does.
Now, what's the line of study that you have all planned out here?
Well, I plan to attend Florida State University this coming summer and study communications there.
And then maybe we will see you on the television.
Yes, hopefully.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
And there you have Lisa Warren. And Michelle Benitez is next. She's from Miami, student at Southwest Senior High School. Tell me, what kind of plan do you have? What would you like to do in the future?
Well, I'd like to become an orthodontist.
You say that without any hesitation.
Nope.
Gosh, you got great teeth, too.
Thank you.
Why? Why do you choose that field?
Well, I like to make people smile, because when you smile at them, they always return a smile, and that makes you feel cheerful and pleasant.
Anybody in your family in that work?
No, nobody in my family.
Did you have an occasion when you were even younger to go into braces and all that sort of business?
Yes, that's why I think, because before I got my braces, I never really smiled very much. But after I had my teeth straightened, I was smiling everywhere I went.
And it's a beautiful smile.
Thank you very much.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
And there is Michelle Benitez. That's right, Debbie, come right on up. Debbie Knox of Miami, 16 years old, Miami Killian Senior High. All right, I see pediatric speech pathology.
Yes, I took a sign language class this summer at Miami-Dade, and I became very interested in helping the hearing impaired. So I'd like to work in that field.
How will you do that? What, again, will be your plan of study?
Well, I'd like to do some of my studying at Duke University, perhaps, and then do my graduate work at Gallaudet University, which is in Washington, D.C. It's a deaf university.
After that, where do you think you might want to spend the major part of your adult life?
Maybe Miami, probably in Miami, but I'd like to go to California also.
Why do you say that?
Because I've been to California and it's a great city, a great state.
So California, you may be a coast-to-coast lady.
Maybe, I hope.
We hope that works out too. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
And that is Debbie Knox. Now, those are just the first of our semifinalists. The rest will come along here in just a moment, and we'll chat with them. Right now, I want you to see what our lucky winner has in store for her.
Our new Miss Florida Teen USA will wow the paparazzi's eyes with beautiful gowns from designer Lori Chambliss. Beaches of Sunny Isles is the perfect setting for the Water Water Everywhere collection. The many styles reflect the different personalities and possibilities of Florida living. Flowers for the pageant were provided by Occasional Flowers of Miami Springs. Lazaro and Mercy always have the perfect flowers for any occasion. Tonight's winner will also receive a $2,000 cash award, Miss Florida Teen USA sash, crown, and trophy, and an all-expense-paid trip to represent the state of Florida in the Miss Teen USA pageant, plus a special surprise.
Miss Florida Teen USA will go to South America, to Ecuador and the marvelous Galapagos Islands on Saeta Airlines with its world-class service, visiting Quito and its colonial treasures high in the Andes Mountains, Guayaquil, and to Galapagos, where Darwin wrote his Origin of the Species. A fascinating cruise on the Galapagos Explorer, an unforgettable trip on Saeta Airlines. Complete tours from Miami, 9 days, including air portions, cruises, hotel, and tours from $990 per person. Saeta Airlines, the airline of Ecuador.
Now it's time to continue the personality competition, and Dick Lamb is ready to continue the interviews with the remainder of our semifinalists.
Yes, indeed we are, and next is Dana Wiener. Dana, come right on out here. Dana is from Boca Raton, 17 years old, Spanish River High School. All right, Dana, what's going to happen for you when you're finished in high school?
Well, I'd like to attend the University of Florida and maybe one day become a teacher.
Would you like to teach the early grades or later on?
Probably high school.
High school. Why?
Because people know what they want to do with their life, and I'd like to help them get there.
Do you have any experience with other young people, for instance? Do you have any younger brothers and sisters in your family?
Yes, I have a younger brother.
How much younger?
12 years.
How do you get along?
Pretty good. He's a cutie. I don't know if he's here or not.
Does he ever listen to what you tell him?
No.
See, that gives you some clue about your teaching career in the future. Dana, did you tell me where you're going to go to school and everything?
Probably University of Florida.
And then on to the teaching career.
Hopefully.
We'll see you in the classroom and good luck.
Thank you.
There's Dana Wiener. Okay, Laura, you're next. Laura Cuda from Orlando, 18 years old, a Winter Park High School graduate. Are you modeling now?
Yes, I am. I'm modeling full-time in Orlando, and I'm also a modeling instructor at John Casablancas in Orlando. So this has helped me a lot with my own career as well, helping other young girls get their modeling career started.
Where do you hope to go with that career?
I don't know. My goal is to study acting and become a well-known actress. Modeling only is very short-lived, and I feel that acting could carry on throughout my life, and I'm very interested in acting.
Ever done any?
I've done a few television commercials. The biggest commercial that I did was for Wet n Wild Water Park in Orlando. And it was, you know, nothing big, but I'd like to get into the movies. I'm very interested in this.
Well, acting, modeling, again, we wish you the best.
Thank you very much.
Good luck, Laura Cuda. And Virginia, come on out. Virginia Norton from Jacksonville, Bowles High School, 16. Let me see what I can pick up here. Were you at a cooking contest?
Yes, I was. I love to cook anything and everything and then eat it. I've been involved in a local contest, the Jacksonville Journal, but I guess my biggest one was a 17 magazine contest, and that leads directly to the American Culinary Institute in Hyde Park, New York. And I guess that's the Harvard of the cooking world.
Well, what kind of cooking did you do?
Oh, you have to plan a theme party, and since I'm a teenager who enjoys to do teenage rocking things, I planned Virginia's Hard Rock Cafe and transformed my backyard into New York's infamous Hard Rock Cafe.
I'll bet that was something.
It was a swinging night, trust me, and I think my parents can tell you that too.
And some great burgers on the menu.
Well, I like to think I can do a little bit more than burgers.
I bet you can, and Virginia, good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Virginia Norton. And Dana Rosenhaus from North Miami. You got some fans here, haven't you?
Yes, I do. I've got my whole family here. They're supporting me. They're right over there. I've got my grandpa, my grandmother, my best friends, and their boyfriends. So
tell me about your plans now.
My plans are to follow the footsteps of my family. My father went to the University of Miami, and my brothers went to the University of Miami, and they're doing very well. So I feel that since my brothers and my father have been there, I'd like to go there too, and then I'd like to continue on to law school.
Good enough. We'll see you in court.
I hope so.
Dana Rosenhaus. And Lori, you're next. Lori McGinnis from Plant City. She wants to become a CPA. Is that true?
That's right.
Tell me why.
Well, I would like both my aunt and my uncle are both CPAs, and I would really enjoy it. I love math. And I think that I would be very well in a CPA. Well,
Lori, you sound like you got your feet on the ground.
Oh, yes, sir, I do. And I'm excited.
And a good plan, too. Good luck. Lori McGinnis.
Thank you.
All right, Renee Pitts from Orlando, 17. Well, I see elementary school. Oh, teacher's aide. You still doing that?
No, this year I wasn't able to do that. I have other academic courses I had to take. But last year I was involved with going to elementary schools and helping with the children that are in there. And I worked a lot with the underprivileged children. There's Great Oaks Village, where it's a home where the children are sent when their parents beat them or they're left just alone. And so I work a lot with them with their problems.
You do some singing as well?
Just mess around, nothing major.
Just fun type singing, huh? Well, when you get out of school, what's going to happen for you?
Well, first I think I'm going to take a vacation for maybe a half a year, and then I'm going to plan to go to college to major in psychology and get a job, something with children, because I really love children.
All right, Renee, good luck to you.
Thank you.
There's Renee Pitts. Well, there we have our semifinalists for Poison Personality. And speaking of judging, let me give you the judges, please. I'd like to introduce our good panel of judges to you at this time. First of all, we have a lady who is here with us, has an extensive background in business, politics, and in tourism. She recently has been added to the staff of the Florida Department of Commerce Office of Sports Promotion in Tallahassee. And she is Cheryl LePannon. Next, a gentleman who is a native Texan. He's been with us in Florida for about 8 years now. He has a 20-year career record in the travel industry. He is now the senior vice president of Windstar Sail Cruises. Please meet Ron Kurtz. Next, a good lady who's a native of Fort Myers, a graduate of Florida Atlantic University. She's marketing and public relations coordinator for Palm Air Spa Resort, which is one of the top 10 spa resorts in the country. And she is Martha Gales. Very distinguished gentleman next on our panel is the man really behind the Miss USA beauty pageants. Over 30 years ago, this gentleman came up with the idea that has inspired thousands of young ladies all over the world to compete as Miss Universe or Miss USA, and most recently as Miss Teen USA. He's the past president of Miss Universe Incorporated, Mr. Harold Glasser. And finally, a native of Miami, well-known designer of formal gowns for entertainers, socialites, and pageant contestants. She's the owner of Lori Chambliss Design Salon. Lori Chambliss. Those are our judges. The next bit of competition is in swimsuit. We'll be back with it in just a moment. Stay tuned.
The next name called could be yours. If you're between the ages of 14 and 18, applications are now being accepted for the 1990 Miss Florida Teen USA pageant. It's the official preliminary for the Miss Teen USA pageant. For more information, send a postcard with your name, address, telephone number, and date of birth to Tel Air Interest, 1755 Northeast 149th Street, Miami, Florida, 33181.
Welcome back to the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant. It's time now for the second part of tonight's competition, the swimsuit category. The contestants will be judged on poise and physical condition. Now, here's Dick with the contestants.
Sherry, we're all ready to go. Our 12 semifinalists in swimsuit competition, beginning with Kimberly Polk. Kimberly Polk from Leesburg. High school student, she is 18 years old. Next is Karen Cash. Karen is 17 years old, her home is Miami. Tina Cirillo. Tina from North Miami Beach, 17 years old. Lisa Warren. Lisa, 17-year-old high school student from Clearwater. Michelle Benitez. Michelle is 15 and she's from Miami. And next, here is Debbie Knox. Debbie, also from Miami. Miami Killian Senior High, she's 16. Dana Wiener. Dana's from Boca Raton. Spanish River High School student, she's 17. Laura Cuda. Laura is from Orlando. Out of Winter Park High School, she's now a model. Virginia Norton. From Jacksonville. Virginia is 16. Student at Bowles High School. Dana Rosenhaus. North Miami, North Miami Beach Senior High School. She's 17 years old. Lori McGinnis. Lori is 16. Her home is Plant City. Renee Pitts. Seventeen years old, Renee from Orlando, student at William R. Boone High School. And now we'll have our semifinalists all come forward and model for our judges.
You've just seen two categories of tonight's competition, and the most elegant part is still to come with the evening gowns. This is where the contestants get to show their flair for fashion. We'll be back with the evening gown competition right after these messages.
Introducing AmberVision, the most amazing breakthrough in vision technology since glasses were invented. These super glasses actually improve vision indoors, outdoors, day or night. We guarantee it. Look, AmberVision blocks the blurring blue rays, the same rays that cause haze and fog.
Everything is so much crisper and clearer.
I can't believe my own eyes. They're amazing.
AmberVision blocks 100% of the dangerous ultraviolet light with UV-400, the best protection for your eyes. You'll wear these high-fashion glasses all year round, and one size fits all.
Oh, I can't believe the difference.
Catalogs offer similar glasses for $59.95, but now you can order AmberVision for just $10 on this special offer. Seeing is believing, so order AmberVision today.
Clip-on model is also available. Credit card users call 1-800-445-4100. That's 1-800-445-4100. Or send just $10 plus $250 shipping to AmberVision, Box 700-J, Verona, New Jersey, 07044.
Now we're ready for evening gown competition indeed, the most elegant part of our program. Our young ladies, in a gown of their choosing, will come out now. They'll be judged on poise and charm and a sense of fashion. Let's begin evening gown competition for our semi-finalist. And once again, here is Kimberly Polk. Kimberly from Leesburg, young lady interested in fashion design and in modeling. She's been a member of Who's Who among American high school students, has an Excellence in Photography award to her credit. Next is Karen Cash. Karen from Miami. Also interested in fashion. High school student now at Miami Palmetto Senior High. Tina Cirillo. First year at St. Leo College. Dancing, acting, her fields of interest. Lisa Warren. from Clearwater. High school student at Clearwater High. Lisa, interested in television, would like to be a news anchor woman. Michelle Benitez. Michelle from Miami, 15 years old, would like to be an orthodontist. Leisure time, enjoys reading. Likes to go fishing with her dad. Here is Debbie Knox. Debbie's from Miami. Miami Killian Senior High. Interested in the field of pediatric speech pathology. Dana Wiener. She's from Boca Raton. Student at Spanish River High School. Among other things, she's received the coaches awards for cross country. Laura Kuda. From Orlando, Laura came out of Winter Park High School. Modeling now. Also interested in acting. Virginia Norton. Virginia from Jacksonville, 16, goes to Bowles High School. Already won several cooking contests. Dana Rosenhaus. North Miami Beach Senior High School. Seventeen years old. Says she'd like to be a lawyer. Lori McGinnis. From Plant City, 16. She's our math lady. Wants to become a CPA. She's been on the student council, been class president. Renee Pitts. Renee's from Orlando. 17 years old. She's been a teacher's aide before. Hobbies that include dancing, singing, and modeling.
Now that all three categories are over, have you at home picked your top five? The judges have, and we'll be back with the announcement of the five that are still in the running for the crown after these messages.
Miami Seaquarium says thanks, South Florida, for your support. Hi, I'm Mark, trainer at the Miami Seaquarium. Haven't you ever wanted to be a trainer for a day? Well, now through Christmas, we're giving away prizes every hour, including Kodak cameras, Sea Escape cruises, T-shirts, and a once-in-a-lifetime experience to be a trainer for a day. Go to your participating Wendy's and pick up a discount coupon, and it's our way of saying thanks, South Florida.
Come on out for a day of fun at the Miami Seaquarium.
Miss Teen USA!
Miss Teen USA!
The next name called could be yours. If you're between the ages of 14 and 18, applications are now being accepted for the 1990 Miss Florida Teen USA pageant. It's the official preliminary for the Miss Teen USA pageant. For more information, send a postcard with your name, address, telephone number, and date of birth to Tel Air Interest, 1755 Northeast 149th Street, Miami, Florida, 33181.
Introducing Popeat, the amazing new food storage system with an incredible accordion construction that actually expands and collapses. You create the size you need. Collapse the container to fit the food to save the space. Only one glass left. Put it in Popeat and look at the difference. Do your cabinets look like this? With Popeat, you'll save so much space it's like having an extra cabinet in your kitchen. Complete with airtight lids to keep food its absolute freshest. They're dishwasher safe and microwave safe. You'll get 3-quart size Popeat, 3-quart and a half size pieces, 3 half-gallon pieces, and the giant half-gallon bottle that collapses this small for easy travel. Now only $19.95. 9 containers, the bottle, lids, 20 pieces in all. Here's how to order.
Credit card users call toll-free 1-800-272-8900. That's 1-800-272-8900. Or send just $19.95 plus $3 shipping to Popeat Box 700-H, Verona, New Jersey 07044. Or call 1-800-272-8900.
Well, here we go. Now, you talk about the tough part. You got to take these 12 beautiful young ladies and narrow the number just to 5. Our judges have done it, and now I'm going to announce our 5 finalists for the title of Miss Florida Teen USA. Ladies, here it comes, and good luck now to all of you. Our first finalist is Debbie Knox. Our next finalist, Laura Kuda. Finalist, Renee Pitts. Two more lucky young ladies in our group of finalists. The next name is Karen Cash. One more name. The next finalist is Kimberly Polk. Ladies and gentlemen, our finalists for Miss Florida Teen USA.
Is pageant time throughout the United States as competitions are held to select the young ladies going to the Miss USA and Miss Teen USA pageant. In fact, it was just 2 years ago when our hostess for tonight's pageant, Sherry Smeltzer, was a Miss Arkansas USA contestant. Sherry wants to take us back to Arkansas and show us how they prepare for their competition. With the help of Lisa and the Cult Jam, we're going to watch behind the scenes and show some pageantry fun as the girls prepare themselves from head to toe.
A year ago, a beautiful young lady from Ocala won the hearts and the votes of our judges and became Miss Florida Teen USA. And now already, how quickly it rolls around, she's here with the farewell to her title. Ladies and gentlemen, Holly Nicholson.
Representing my state as Miss Florida Teen USA has been an honor I will truly cherish always. I've had the opportunity to meet many new and exciting people who have touched my life in many ways. My deepest thanks to my family for all the love and support that they have given me this year. A warm thanks to Mr. and Mrs. Gravett for all the love and understanding you have shown me. You have helped me change my life in a special way. Also, Grant Jr., Lily, and the Tella-Air family, you're great people to work with. Thank you. Lloyd, thanks for designing this beautiful gown I'm wearing today. Carolyn, thanks so much for always being there. Wendy, Linda, Sherry, and the rest of my friends, I love you. Thanks for your support. To my successor, I wish you the best of luck, love, and happiness throughout your year and the rest of your life. May God always bless you.
Holly Nicholson, our reigning Miss Florida Teen USA, who will now help us crown her successor. And I am ready now to get the final information, the final vote of our judges from our tabulator, Dan Emke. Dan with Tate & Company, the CPA firm in Miami Lakes. Thank you, Dan. All right, ladies, here we are. That's right, grasp hands, support one another. You're all ready. I'll begin with the announcement of our fourth runner-up, Laura Kuda. And next, our third runner-up, Kimberly Polk. Brings us to our second runner-up, Renee Pitts. And now one of these two young ladies, one will be the first runner-up and the other will be our new Miss Florida Teen USA. Ladies and gentlemen, the first runner-up is Karen Cash, our Miss Florida Teen USA is Debbie Knox. Debbie Knox is our winner. Debbie Knox from Miami, 16 years old, a student at Miami Killian Senior High. She is the new Miss Florida Teen USA. And as always, having difficulty getting crown and sash and everything that she needs to present herself to her audience for the first time as Miss Florida Teen USA. You may have to hold it on, Debbie, as you go. Debbie Knox, the stage is yours. Well, Debbie, come join me for just a second. Don't run away. You're losing your crown, kiddo.
Thank you so much. I can't believe it.
Want me to follow you and hold that up for you?
If you'd like.
You did a great job.
Thank you.
You're just a little bit excited.
Just a little.
We'll be rooting for you in a big way in the Miss Teen USA pageant. Good luck to you there.
Thank you so much. I love you all.
Debbie Knox, our new Miss Florida Teen USA. This is Dick Lamb. Thank you all for joining us.
Congratulations to our new Miss Florida Teen USA 1989. Tonight we've watched as one special young lady's life has been changed forever. Ahead of her is a year full of new experiences and excitement, with the best being her proudly representing Florida in the 1989 Miss Teen USA pageant. I want to thank all of the contestants for their participation in this year's pageant and extend a special thank you to the people of Sunny Isles and their support in making this event so special. From Sunny Isles, this is Sherry Smeltzer saying good night.